Chris.
I have the mask on.
Shined. You have multiplied the nation.
You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder.
Join me in our prayer of the day. Almighty God, you
made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence and in the last day awake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
You may be seated.
When Quirinius was governor of Syria, everyone had to travel to his own ancestral hometown to be accounted for. So Joseph went from the Galilean town of Nazareth up to Bethlehem in Judah, David's town, for the census. As a descendant of David, he had to go there. He went with Mary, his fiancée, who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger because there was no room in the hospital.
Christ our joy, please pour out more.
were shepherders camping in the neighborhood. They had set night watches over their sheep. Suddenly, God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everybody worldwide. A Savior has just been born in David's town, a Savior who is Messiah and Master. This is what you're to look for, a baby wrapped in a blanket and lying in a manger." At once, the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir singing God's praises. Glory to God in the heavenly heights. Peace to all men and women on earth who please Him. As the angel choir withdrew into heaven, the shepherds talked it over. "Let's get over to Bethlehem as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us." They left, running, and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. Seeing was believing. They told everyone they met what the angels had said about this child. All who heard the shepherds were impressed. Mary kept all these things to herself, holding them dear, deep within herself. The shepherds returned and let loose, glorifying and praising God for everything they had heard and seen. It turned out exactly the way they'd been told.
Thank you.
Christmas Eve meditation for tonight. Really, almost a week ago now, because I get to go on vacation starting tomorrow, and so I was knocking out every single to-do list that I possibly could leading up to that. And then yesterday, I got a text from my sister, who, if you don't know, my sister in Montana has been pregnant and due with her second baby due January 4th. And I got a text yesterday saying that she was at the hospital, high blood pressure, and positive for COVID. She's fully vaxxed, and so I was grateful that she'd only been having a headache, but with everything going on, they decided to induce. And so from yesterday, when I sent Margaret that email requesting prayers, it's been a lot of waiting. And I keep thinking about waiting for a baby in this whole month of Advent, this whole season where we get ready and wait and celebrate together Christmas. I kept thinking about, now I really know viscerally this feeling of waiting for a baby, waiting for news. And this afternoon, while I was on my way to go over to King's Manor to provide a worship service there for today, I got the text with a little picture of my brand new baby niece, Willow Rose. She was born this afternoon, healthy, mom is doing good, and I'm so incredibly grateful, and that incredible sigh of relief just came over me. And then it was all celebration, and my response text was just, So during this season, I know, right? During this season of waiting, now we finally come to Christmas Eve, that moment where we get to celebrate this baby born to us. And whatever chaos or stress or grief or busyness we might be dealing with during this time, you're here, whether with us in person or online, creating some space tonight for that joy, for the joy of a new baby born into the world. And this baby that we talk about, that we celebrate tonight, is so much more. I think about those shepherds waiting in the fields, keeping watch, the silence just before the angel appears to them, the silence that happens right as the world is being changed. Because I know that in that night when Mary and Joseph are wherever they are that is surrounded by animals and a manger, I love the song we just sang, The Friendly Beast. I haven't actually heard that before. And I just imagine the noise and the chaos and the waiting and the urgency. And then suddenly this baby is here, and now there's the crying and the diapers, I guess. Who packed those? I need to know. I have questions. And I think about all of that, and then hours later, one of the other texts I got today was a picture of my sister and the baby just sleeping in her arms. And that silence, that quiet peace that you get holding this precious gift. That silence that I wonder happens between Mary and Joseph after Jesus finally falls asleep in his mother's arms. The silence we need so much with all the chaos in our lives. The silence of the people from Isaiah who walk in shadows. The silence of those of us who have been waiting. I think during this time of joy and celebration and finding safe ways to gather together with family and friends, sometimes we just need a moment of silence. As God's angel stands around the shepherds, God's glory blazed around them, lighting the night sky, filling the silence with great and joyful news. Great news meant for everybody, worldwide, joyful news for the whole world. I imagine the blinding light, if you've been standing in the dark for so long, when the angel appears with joy and celebration and song, because a savior has just been born in David's town in Bethlehem, a savior who is Messiah, a savior who is amazing counselor, strong God, Prince of Peace, a child born in a manger. This child who shines a light in the shadows. This child who brings joy and celebration to those who wait, to us. Because this child, this baby who's laid in blankets in a manger is for us. This Jesus is for the world, bringing peace to the chaos, bringing love and care to those keeping watch at night. This child, this Jesus, whose birth, whose life, whose death and resurrection gives forgiveness, grace, and love to the entire world. Through this child, the Son of God, salvation's available for everyone. Grace is here. This new life that we celebrate today, this is a new life for us. A child born for us. For us who might be in some deep shadows right now. For us who wait in silence. For all who are in need of those moments of peace or grace or just deep care. God gives us a light, a song, a savior, a newborn king. Thanks be to God. And Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
I invite you to stand as you are comfortable for our hymn of the day.
Thank you.
this time, we are not passing around an offering plate during our service, but there is one available as you exit at the sanctuary today, if you would so choose. We lift our voices, our hands, our lives up to our Lord in response to the generous gifts God shares with us. Each week we share our gifts for ministry and our offering. We give thanks for the gifts God shares with us. We give thanks for the abundant life God brings us. And we give thanks for you. Holy God, your beauty shines forth from the manger, and your love flows from the cross. As you gather us around these signs of your love, come among us, warm us to extend your care among the hungry and all in need. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. Holy One, the beginning and the end, the giver of life, blessed are you for the birth of creation. Blessed are you in the darkness and in the light. Blessed are you for your promise to your people. Blessed are you in the prophets' hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your son Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, Jesus took the cup. He gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
With this bread and cup, we remember your word dwelling among us, full of grace and truth. We remember our new birth in his death and resurrection. We look with hope for his coming.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Holy God, we long for your spirit. Come among us. Bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awaken your people. Fill us with your light. Bring the gift of peace on earth.
Come, Holy Spirit.
All praise and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, power of the Most High, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
I invite you to pray with me the prayer that our Lord Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
You may be seated. Know that all are welcome to the Lord's table. You do not need to be a member of our church or denomination to commune with us. During this time, we commune at once together, so please take a moment to prepare the elements that you would have received as you came into the sanctuary today. And taking a look, making sure it looks like everyone is doing pretty good there. In Christ's manger, at Christ's table, come and see what God makes known for you. Dear ones, this is the body of Christ, given for you. Amen. This is the blood of Christ, shed for you.
Thank you.
you to stand as you are comfortable. Now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace and peace.
Amen. Amen.
We thank you, wondrous God, for Jesus, God with us, in these gifts of bread and wine, as we share this feast of love, strengthen us to share your love with all the world. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
And so just before I read our John reading, we are going to begin lighting our candles. Is there a plan?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I am.
We can go ahead and get that started. The Word was first. The Word present to God, God present to the Word was God. In readiness for God from day one, everything was created through him. Nothing, not one thing, came into being without him. What came into existence was life, and the life was light to live by. The life light blazed out of the darkness. The darkness couldn't put it out.
Jesus, Lord.
May Christ, who by his incarnation has filled us with grace and truth, give you peace this Christmas and always. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.
Amen. Amen.